puts West Georgia all the way back to their own 11, and the defense was there again. This drive looked a lot like their opening drive of the first half. A Holloway run, a Gray rush, and a pass play that ends up falling incomplete. But again, the defense, you know, it seems like they don't worry about what the scoreboard is.
No, they just had, yeah, this whole last game, they came out hungry, ran around, pursued to the football the whole game, really played a, just a, an outstanding game. Very, very happy with the defense in terms of what they did.
So I know Squirewell got a little bit of hack for this one, dropping the INT, but you know, he was on the play.
Yeah, he apologized to me after the game. He was joking around with me about that. I'll get you one next time. So it was nice to see a Georgia native there coming out, starting his first game, doing a great job for us.
So here's a first play from the 35 for 35 yards, right back into that groove, and another perfect pass. Halfley just sticking in the pocket and bailing out down the field, and then you know, a couple short runs by Vince, but you know, he's always getting. You always want to see him get positive yardage, and being that strong, it always happens.
Absolutely, positive plays. That's all we're looking for. And even if it's just a few yards, it's moving the chains. It's moving us in the right direction.
So the Bulldogs again go Vince four straight times, 2 yards, 7 yards, no gain, and then the first down here on fourth down right here, just off that right edge, and Vince needed two. He got plenty, and then here's the next play again. That wide receiver screen. You know, as you said, any guy could get it. This time is Phil.
Yep. And again, just trying to get it out to the athletes out in space. You know, on first down, if we can get 4 or 5 in that play with a good athlete, we'll take it.
I thought Nelson again, right back up the middle.
I thought he was gone. I thought that one was going to be in. Did a nice job, nice little cut back here. Kept the shoulders down, kept his feet pumping. Nice hold by the offensive line.
So two plays, didn't score on first and second down. Here's Halfley, stuck it over both officials. Coach, say touchdown, no dispute. You know, we got a great picture of it on the Wingate website. You know, it was a good play for that situation. You guys up 7-0.
Yeah, it was Coach. You know, we were an inch away, so all we had to do was put the ball over a little. And it's a little dangerous, but we got it done.
So the Bulldogs take the 7-0 lead. Right back comes West Georgia. And really not much to do on offense. Again, another 3-and-out. We'll see a good pressure here by Simmons. And, you know, they had a couple drops on the possession. But regardless, your team gets the ball right back. And we fast forward all the way down. Here's that great pass and catch from the 37 to Bowden stepping in on the sideline.
That was a great hookup there in terms of nice throw, kind of threading the needle. Real nice just tiptoeing along the sidelines there with Chris, just keeping it in bounds. Great throw and catch.
Ball all the way up to the West Georgia 18-yard line. And back to Woods. He'll go straight up the middle. Again, another nice gain on first down, 5 yards. Woods, as we know, close to breaking the all-time school records and sure. Already has the carries record, looking for touchdowns and yards.
Yep, just banging it in there again, just a real workhorse that he's been for a number of years now.
And surprisingly, doesn't have a lot of reception for touchdowns. And Halfley here, maybe you'd like to see him get rid of it a little bit earlier. He had him open. But looking downfield.
Yeah, he was trying to look for the deep one first. But again, positive yards, positive play. And again, really nice play here by Woods in terms of leading Cody out in front
right.
After the fake.
Great block.
Yeah, does a nice job here of blocking the linebacker and keeping him off. And Cody taking a big hit there.
So again, inside the two, couple plays, don't get the first down. And then the tough pass there by Halfley. It was hard, but you know, Floyd, as good as he is, probably should have caught it.
Yeah, and you know, I think Perry was thinking – throttle down out of there, and Cody was thinking he was going to keep going, so just a little miscommunication.
So you decide not to go for it, go with the field goal, RP.
Trying to make it a two-possession
right.
game. You know, at this point it was a back and forth. We definitely wanted to make it a two-possession game at that point.
So Wingate takes a 10-0 lead going into the fourth quarter. Bulldogs start the fourth quarter with the ball. West Georgia gets it back after the punt. Have a good drive going, get down to the Wingate 32, and they try to set up a little screen here, and it's busted play. Pretty good. Again, we said it a lot. The pursuit was good, and then good tackle here by Morris on a little pass in the flat.
Again, that was one thing that we figured West Georgia would and try to get the ball to their athletes out in open space and challenge us to tackle them, which we did, and that's something this week will be important for us as well.
Big play here for Simmons coming from the weak side.
This was outstanding.
And just what a play.
You know, we knew one thing about Jonathan. We knew he could run well. We knew he had some good acceleration, but it was nice to see it, you know, come to fruition here and be able to run him down and pull him down. It's a huge play for us.
Sack for the loss for 2 yards ends up causing a missed field goal. And on second down on the very next drive, Perry rarely gets run down. Coach, dangerous play here. It looks like a horse car.
It really should have been a horse car. I'm not sure what the thinking was there, why it wasn't called. He kind of lets go as he's coming down. I'm not sure why that wasn't called, but I'm not complaining. It was a nice reception to get us down into their territory.
Very next play, halfway, just a quick glance to the left, and probably thought Bowden might have had this. Kind of, with the defender hand in his face, might have lost it.
Yeah, that's one we see that ball go up, and we see our wideouts come down with that one so often. From my vantage point, I couldn't see exactly what was happening. But a good effort by Chris.
Short gain for Vince here on second down, and then on third down you call Floyd's number. Mm-hmm. You got fourth and four. You call the timeout, and that incomplete pass. As there's
that
a pass
nice
to Floyd.
This would have been a good. This was a key drive for us. If we punch it in here and go up 17-0 at this point, it's at that point we're just going to run out the clock. So disappointing. We weren't able to necessarily get what we needed.
The play changed with the false start.
We a couple things. We went through a couple different options and decided to come back with something a little different. Phil had an opportunity here, just I think he thought the guy was going to tip it, so he was playing more for the tip than anything. And but they will come up with that catch more than we want.
If you have a weak stomach here, look away. Henson coming right up the middle and just absolutely lays a lick on Behena, who just came in the game. Incomplete pass there, and then a nice greeting on his second play, a great lick by Terrence.
Yeah, and there's two good players for him. Ben's definitely one of the tougher guys on the team. And he'll strike you a lick. There's no doubt about that. Terrence obviously played a great game as well.
Second play again for Bahana. You see, trying to get to the outside. West Georgia quarterbacks like to run. Then a third down here, Coach. West Georgia's third and short. Maybe thought they'd keep it on the ground, but they go to the air, get 20 yards and a first down to keep the drive alive. Bahana obviously had a big spark. We fast forward all the way up to the touchdown pass. Take us through this play.
Well, Justin had played well all game. He was reaching back trying to feel for him, like we do with the corners. He was trying to feel for him, and he couldn't feel it. Like, he missed him when he reached back. Slowed up because he thought the receiver had broken out. And had a nice throw and catch. Defense played well, and that's the way it goes. They're well coached too. They're going to make some plays as well.
Opponents were 3-for-3 against you in onside kicks last year. Good start
and
here.
Don't you think I wasn't thinking about that?
Great hands there by Phil Thomas, and now they're going to call timeout. Couple runs, you just need one first down. Right. Ever think about going to the air here?
The thought did cross my mind. Sure. Yeah. But at this point, you're thinking, we don't want a quick score. We don't want them to score quickly.
Right.
So what is it that, kind of the most conservative thing, just keep it on the ground. Particularly after we kind of got stuffed on first down, I was like, all right, let's see what happens. And fortunately, we kind of banged it through here a little bit.
An Allen way the opposite side, two plays in a row, and it worked both times.
Right. And that's just, again, just schematically, we felt like that was the best situation to put us in with that personnel group out there. And again, going to Nelson here in the clutch, just trying to bang it out and see what he can do. At that point, we'll just say, put the ball in the senior's hands, let him do his thing. This obviously was huge.
Needed four, got nine, and that ends it. You see all the offensive linemen run up after him. They knew it was over, and I got to call the last play of the game, actually. You change it to the Joe Reich play, and here it is right here. There it is, Cody Hafley, the kneel down.
Right, yes.
Favorite play, and Wingate wins it 10-7 on the road at West Georgia. So I want to know, start, Coach, nothing new for your team. The second and third games have always been really tough in the non-conference, mm-hmm. seems like, in the past. This one may be one of the toughest ever. At Valdosta, didn't play great the first game, but, hey, at least there's mm-hmm. room to improve, and you'll need to, obviously, with the Blazers coming up.
And I think the common thing is you should make your biggest improvement from the first game to the second game. So I think for us that's going to be important to, we've had a good week of practice, and now let's go out and make sure that we show that there's certain advantages to playing a team that hasn't played yet, and there are certain advantages to being the team that hasn't played yet and playing a team that has. Because, that first time they see they see your strengths, they see your weaknesses. Certainly Valdosta is a good football team, and we're looking forward to going down there. It's should be a good experience for us.
Yeah, I just talked to Tyrone Scott, and he said, best place he's played yet as a Wingate Bulldog, no doubt West Georgia.
Absolutely.
But I said, you know, what if I ask you next week, you know, it might be Valdosta. You know, what do you tell the guys and say, you know, outside of the actual wins and losses, you know, you got to enjoy this experience. Yeah. And they should enjoy it Saturday at Valdosta.
Yeah, and it really, that you're absolutely right. It's you know, this is the experience. They're playing college football. There are thousands of people that would love to have this opportunity, millions of people that would love this opportunity. And so our guys, you know, we tell them, look, enjoy this experience. This is, you know, you're in the prime of your life to a certain extent. You're playing college football. You traveled last week to West Georgia with the facilities were unbelievable. Just really nice facilities. Now you're going down to play a team, Valdosta, that has very similar facilities and has a great reputation. Just enjoy every opportunity. Enjoy every moment you get. And I know as a 45-year-old head coach, I'm enjoying.
Right.
You know, I'm enjoying, hey, this is just a great opportunity for us, great experience in life. And, you know, we'll keep pounding away.
Well, the Bulldogs and Blazers will kick it off 7 p.m. Saturday night at Valdosta. Wingate will then have the 11th off and have their first home football game on September 18th. We'll talk to you, obviously, before then. Coach Reich, best of luck Saturday night, and thanks for being here.
Thanks, Ryan. I appreciate it. My pleasure.
Blair.